Hello everybody and welcome back to the system hacking section. Now, in the previous videos we saw how we can actually create some of the exploits for the OWASP virtual machine, and we were able to hack a Linux server with the PHP interpreter shell. Now, as we finished with those Tomcat and Apache 2 exploits, now we are going to continue to the Windows exploits. Now, this is some of the more important parts, since most of the people use Windows and since most vulnerable software is actually run on Windows. So out of all of the other operating systems, Windows is the most vulnerable one. It had in the past bunch of these vulnerabilities, such as the one I told you before, the Eternal Blue, which we will be doing. It is a vulnerability for the Windows 7 all packs and basically Windows, I believe, Server 2008. And they have some additional Metasploit modules for the Windows 8 and Windows 10, but I couldn't seem to get those to work, so we will be doing the regular Eternal Blue exploit. But before we actually continue with exploiting Windows with Metasploit, let us just install a program that we will need now in this section, and it will also need once we start actually coding our own programs in Python. The program is called Wine. Now, Wine is basically a program for Linux that allows Linux users to actually run Windows programs in Linux. What I mean by that is basically, for example, the executable Windows extension is .exe. Every .exe file that you run is basically only executable on Windows. You cannot run it on Linux. So, in order for us to run some of the programs that are .exe or .msi, basically we will need to install Wine in order to do that on Linux. Now, there are two reasons why we need it currently. One of them is that Wine is actually required as a program in order to be able to run the Eternal Blue NSA exploit on Windows 7, which is one of the more important exploits that we will do. And the other reason is that we will need Wine in order to make our Python programs in Linux .exe later on when we start coding our own programs. So let us start off by actually downloading it. So I already have it installed. I will show you how to perform that, and we will also install our first Windows program and use it in our Wine program. We will install Python for Windows and use it as a Wine installer. So you will see what I mean soon enough. Let me just enlarge this so you can see a little bit better what I'm doing. So if you just type here Wine in Kali Linux, wine --help, you should get prompted with this, since I believe Wine is already pre-installed in Kali Linux. But if you ran a 64-bit version of Kali Linux, I believe that you will need to upgrade and add some architecture for the 32-bit. So we also want to install Wine 32-bit. Now, I already installed it and I will show you what is the command in order to perform the installation. So just type in your terminal dpkg, then --, add architecture. And basically what you want is i386 for the 32-bit version. Now, this is just one of the three commands that we want to run in order to install. So let us actually run all three at the same time. So let me add these two signs in order to continue with another command. And that would be apt-get-update. And the third command, which we want to do, is apt-get-install Wine 32. So as we can see, first of all, we are adding the architecture for i386, and then we're updating our repositories, and after that we're actually installing the Wine 32-bit. Now, the apt-get install Wine 32-bit won't really work without this command, so we need to run this first. Now, since I already ran this before, I will not be running it at the moment, since I already have Wine installed. And what you want to do, basically, this process, I believe, especially if you didn't update your Kali Linux repositories for longer, will take around 20 to 30 minutes. If you did update your repositories, however, it shouldn't take too long, so you will be good to go. So after you run that, what you want to do is basically, let us go to the Python website and actually download the MSA installer for Python 2. So I already did all of that, but I will show you how you can do it, since it is important for future videos, especially now Python we do not need for the exploit module that we will use in the next videos, but we will need it in our coding section. So, start new session, we want to start new one, and what we want to go, just go to your web page and just type here HTTPS, then we want to go to the www.python.org. And basically what you want to go is to this link right here, so /downloads/release and then python-2714, which is the Python 2. Now the reason why we are not using Python 3 is because most of the older programs and older modules and libraries in Python are still supported as Python 2. And for me personally, Python 2 is basically a little easier, since it doesn't include some brackets and all of that, which I always forget to include in Python 3. But I will show you the syntax for both once we get to that. For now on, I just want to show you how you can install this. So, once you're on this page, you want to scroll down, and you will get this bunch of versions of Python right here, or basically the installer for Python. What you want to do is basically go all the way down to the Windows x86 MSA installer. Once you do that, go click on it. It will ask you, do you want to install Python 2.7.14.msi? The size is 18 megabytes. You want to save that file, and it will save that file right here in your downloads folder. As we can see, if I open my downloads folder, it will show two times Python 2.7.14, because I already installed one yesterday, so we can just delete one, or let me open in terminal and then I will delete Python 2.7.14. It doesn't matter, one of them has to go, or basically it doesn't, so I just want to delete it so I don't have the duplicate. And what you want to do after that is basically you can just, let me just close this, we do not need this browser opened anymore. What you want to do is change your directory to downloads, and if you click here ls, you will see your Python file right here, and the next thing you want to do is wine, and then msi exec, I believe, and then /i, and then Python. I believe the syntax looks something like this, we will check it right now. It should work, and after that it should start loading your Wine program. Now, since I already did install it, what you want to do is basically just click on Next everywhere, and basically you want to install it in the C drive. It will create a virtual C drive for your Kali Linux machine, and once you've finished the installation, just click on Finish. I will go on X right here, since I already have it. Are you sure you want to cancel the installation? Yes. And then Finish. So, everything has finished. Now, once you finish the installation, what you want to do is basically navigate to your C drive. Now C drive is something you find in Windows, not in Linux, but for Wine created a virtual C drive with basically Windows modules, libraries and all of that, that allow us to run Windows executables. So in order to go there, you need to go to the root. Then if you click on the root ls, you will notice that there is nothing named as Wine. Now Wine basically is a hidden file in this directory, and you can find it in two ways. One of them is basically you can just go find root directory, click on right click, I believe, and you can go properties, not really sure if access files change permissions. I thought it would be something like show hidden files, but it doesn't matter. Another way that you can do is just type ls-la, which is command that we covered, so you will see all of the files, including hidden files as well. So if you look closely, you will see lower that we have a .wine directory, which is a hidden directory, so basically everything that starts with .dot will be a hidden file in your directory. And we want to go to that directory, so just type cd.wine, and then if we clear the screen and type ls once again, you will see that we actually have our drive _c directory. So we change our directory to there. We can ls, and right here you will see that we actually have basically all of the Windows files installed. Program files, Windows users, Python 27 is the Python that we installed previously. So this is not currently in need for us, but we will be using, as I said, it later on. So it's good to show you an example of making a Windows file executable on Linux. So now if you, for example, if I change my directory to Python and I ls here, you will see python.exe, which is a Windows executable. In order for you to run it, you would need to type wine python.exe. So you would not be able to run it with basically slash and then basically dot slash and then python.exe. You would need to specify wine before that. So I just wanted to show you that this is just a basic wine installation. What we will do in the next videos is we will start exploiting both Windows 7, Windows 10 and maybe Windows XP. And I will show you how you can craft your own payloads with MSF Venom in more detail and how you can actually exploit the Windows both with the payload being delivered by you and both without payload even being delivered with zero-day exploits such as Eternal Blue. Well, I mean, they were zero-day exploits, now they are mostly patched. But I'll show you how they work, since a lot of the devices are still vulnerable to that attack. Since it is an attack on Windows 7, most people still do use Windows 7, and most people do not update their Windows. So you will be able to find some of the devices that are still vulnerable to this attack. But more about that in the next videos. I just want to show you this fine installation, and we will continue hacking in the next lecture. Hope I see you there, and take care. Bye.